In the solar system, there are many objects beyond the area that the main eight planets orbit. In this video, we will discuss these objects and structures. In general, trans-Neptunian objects are any small dwarf planets that lie beyond the orbit of Neptune. This includes the former planet Pluto, and many other dwarf planets in the outer solar system, including Eris, Haumea, Orcus, and Sedna, among others. There are hundreds of these objects in the outer solar system, and it's likely that we haven't even discovered all of them yet. These icy worlds take ages to orbit the Sun, and they usually have strange, long orbits. The furthest of these objects, called Sedna, has a highly eccentric and elliptical orbit. When it is closest to the Sun, it is 76 astronomical units away, but when it is furthest, it is a whopping 937 astronomical units away from the Sun. This planet takes just over 11,400 years to complete one orbit. Many of these other objects, while closer, still take hundreds of years to orbit the Sun. There is likely no life present on any of these worlds, as they are too cold and small to sustain any atmosphere suitable for life. You may be familiar with the asteroid belt, the ring of rocky bodies orbiting the Sun between Mars and Jupiter. Well, there is another ring of icy, rocky bodies in the solar system, called the Kuiper Belt. It lies just beyond the orbit of Neptune and extends to about 50 astronomical units away from the Sun. This second belt is much more massive than the asteroid belt, being around 20 times wider and possibly 200 times more heavy. The Kuiper Belt is home to many asteroids and trans-Neptunian objects. In addition, many shorter period comets come from the Kuiper Belt. This region may be a treasure trove of minerals and metals, and it is possible that this region could see the same exploration and exploitation that the asteroid belt will. Another group of objects that resides at the absolute furthest reaches of the solar system is the Oort cloud. This is a cloud of ice and objects that orbit the Sun at extreme distances, and this cloud is thought to span from 2,000 astronomical units away from the Sun to about 200,000 astronomical units away. The Oort cloud is home to longer period comets, as well as many asteroids and likely dwarf planets, but it is mostly made up of various types of ices. The Oort cloud is so far from the Sun that it technically resides in interstellar space, however many of these objects still orbit the Sun. Some of these objects are on their way out of the solar system, some of them are on their way in, and some of them are just orbiting the Sun at a very long distance. It is believed that these objects and ices are materials from the formation of the planets and solar system long ago. Scientists even believe that a star system passed through this cloud around 70,000 years ago. Recently, scientists have detected what seems to be a very massive object in the outer solar system. While they haven't directly seen the object yet, they have been able to see the gravitational effects of this object. If this object is a planet, it has been estimated to have a mass of 5 to 10 times that of Earth, and it may orbit the Sun at around 400 to 800 astronomical units away. While it is most likely that this object is a planet, many other theories have arisen. Perhaps the most interesting theory is that this mysterious mass could be a so-called primordial black hole, which is an extremely small black hole originating from the early universe. The black hole itself would be incredibly small in size, but it would still have the mass of a large planet. Because these tiny black holes are actually estimated to populate the interstellar medium more than rogue planets, it is thought that this theory could hold some credibility, but to be certain, we will have to observe this object directly. Astronomers are still searching for this object, and it is expected that we will know the source of this anomaly by the middle of the decade. Thank you for watching. If you're new to the channel, be sure to stick around for lots of more content.